Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the introduction to Systems Without Limits. My name is Rebecca Shanahan Galagani, and I am the Director of Expansion Systems for Hergenrothe Realty Group. If you are taking my class or will take my class, I start all my classes off the same way. If you can hear my voice and see my screen, if you can go up to your little attendee box and raise your hand, that allows me to make sure that all of my systems are working and that everybody can see and hear me, and we make sure. So if you go up to your little box, there's a questions box. You can actually type in any questions that you have as well. So thank you. I have one person that says they can hear me, so hopefully the rest of you can hear and see my screen. Awesome. Perfect. All right. So let me tell you a little bit about me before I get started. As I said, my name is Becca, and I've been with Keller Williams Realty since 2005. I started off my career in real estate with Keller Williams. I was a market center administrator for an office in Massachusetts. I stayed there for about 5 or 6 years, and I continued to work as an administrator for Keller Williams for about the next 8 or 9 years. I also worked for the Keller Williams International Office training operations folks on how to do their job in the MCA role. And I did that for about 10 years as well. I joined Adam in as part of Hergenrothe Expansion, or as we call it, Her Group, in 2014 as their director of operations. And I have literally not looked back. I love what I do. I love working here at Her Group. And I'm especially passionate about systems. And I'm passionate about training other people who work through systems and models. We developed this class mostly because a lot of people had a lot of questions about how do we do systems here in Her Group. But there's two pieces of it for me, sharing what we do, but also talking about some fundamentals of how to make your business better and how to really think about everything that you do in every part of your business as a system. So one of the things I want you guys to do is, I know some of you are maybe taking this class or have already signed up. Some of you are thinking about signing up. Please use that question box if there's questions that you have about the course, what you want to get out of it, making sure that it's going to be the right thing for you to sign up for. Please type those in the questions box, and I'll definitely answer them when we get to the end. This is a very quick snapshot of what we're going to offer through Systems Without Limits. Also, I tend to tailor it to the people who join my system and my class. So if you join this course with us and there's something that's really important to the majority of the team that we feel would be helpful for everyone, I do try to incorporate that into the curriculum. I haven't already set curriculum, but for me, it's all about making sure that the end user, the person who has decided to trust me with some of their time, gets everything that they need out of the course. So, with that being said, what is a system? Whoops, going the wrong way. What is a system? A system is a set of connected things or parts that form a complex whole. Or it can be a set of principles or procedures according to which something is done, an organized scheme or method. And the reason why I put this up here, and people always are like, Becca, why did you put this first? I think the big reason why I want to put this out there is I firmly believe that the synonyms for system are how I look at systems. Some systems are going to be tangible checklists. 1, 2, 3, you do 1, you do 2, you do 3, you do 4. Some of them are going to be the method. Some of it's going to be about how you do something. Some of it's going to be about why you do something. Some systems are going to be about your approach to doing something else. And some systems are things that you're going to just have to do over and over and over again to make sure that you come up with the process and result that's best for your organization. Nothing that I teach you in this course is going to fit cookie cutter in your team, your model, your business. It's really going to be about a way to think about models and systems. My goal is not just to give you models and systems, but to help you change the way that you look at models and systems. That is actually the thing that I enjoy doing most, teaching people how to look at a system and model a little bit differently. With that being said, what are we going to cover? Well, for me, we're going to cover what systems can do for you. Because the real big thing that we're going to focus on is the fact that as soon as you put a great system in a place, the sooner you get leverage in your position, no matter what position you are in. You could be at the top of an organization or the bottom of an organization. It doesn't really matter. What we actually are just talking about is how to take the hours and minutes that you have in a day. Here at Her Group, we count our days in minutes, not hours. Not everything has to be a 15-minute block. Not everything has to be a 30-minute window. Not everything has to be a 20-step spreadsheet, right? The goal is, how do we look at everything we do on a daily basis and get leverage from it, putting something in it that would give us 5 more minutes in our day, 8 more minutes in our day, something, some system or model that will give us more time in our day. The other thing that we like to look at and that we'll teach you in this course is that the quality of your systems will determine the quality of your business. Now, for me, this has been something that I have seen time over time, you know, in our organization. The more time that I spend and have time to spend on developing the system by which we do something, the quality of our presentation to our customer goes up. The more we think about, organize, strategize, and really determine the best course of action, the end product that we're able to give to our buyer, to our homeowner, to our even our agents that work with us, is always going to be better. So what we're going to talk about is, how do you top grade all your systems? How do you have a system for making your systems better, right? So there is a system for making your systems better, and we'll talk about that as well. The other thing we see with systems, and what I want to teach you, is the quality of the systems will help raise talent to the top of your organization and create opportunities for people in your organization. There's two times that we see people grow in a company. It's the, what I would call the unhealthy growth, which is, we have a problem, we don't know how to fix it, so we throw people at it. That's one way to do it. What I like to see is, when you have a quality system and you've got people maximized within their skills and with their in their gift zone, you're able to show and find people that can rise up. They will come to the top. So if you have a great system, it puts everybody on an even playing field, right? If you've got a system and a model that people can follow, anybody can come and rise to the top if they have the will, the desire, and the capacity to do so. So that's the next thing we'll talk about, is the, how you create quality systems so that you can, A, maximize the output from all of your staff, but also, or people in your organization, not even just staff, but anyone in your organization, and how do you help the talent rise to the top, and then therefore be able to, you know, have a bigger business and create more opportunity. One of the steps that I find in great systems is, a lot of systems folks are very attached to the outcome of their system. So what do I mean by that? When we, as systems folks, create a system, we get attached to it. I created it, therefore it's perfect. It's amazing. And we try to often put square pegs in round holes. What we don't realize is that when we're too attached to the outcome and we don't have a method or a system to evaluate and restructure our systems continually, our competitors will pass us, because somebody is thinking differently, somebody is enhancing, somebody is spending the time and taking the time on systems and adjusting systems to make them better. So we're going to talk about that as well, how to create systems and checks and balances to ensure that your business is constantly growing and evaluating. And what I mean by, and that will also include financials, we are going to talk about how to have a system around financials, spending money, making money, to ensure that you guys are getting the maximum results out of every nickel that you spend and every hour that you spend on staffing. So that's another huge piece that we're going to talk about. The other thing we're going to talk about is not being afraid to take time to make time for creating a new system. I continually will hear people tell me, you know, Becca, I don't have time to sit down and write this all down. I don't have time to tell you all the steps I do to do X, Y, or Z. What I hear when someone tells me that is, you're losing money hand over fist, because in the short amount of time that you could take with someone who's a systems mind, like all of you who would join this course, would allow you to save money, make more money in the long run. So what we do talk about is how to have others help us and how we help others with our system's mind. So how do you get someone to share with you what they need to tell you to create a system? And how do you bring value by creating systems and finding the time to do that? And then the last thing we talk about is how systems are force multipliers. And what do I mean by that? I can have great staff, but if they don't know what they're expected to do, and we're not clear on their goals, and we're not clear on what they need to do and how we're going to hold them accountable, then they're not going to give us the best results. So when we have good systems, and when we are using them from everything from hiring to production to culture, we're going to talk about how this culture, creating a culture is a system. Everything will force, that's what we call a force multiplier. Having great systems provides focus and direction and allows everybody to be pulling or pushing on the same lever. When you do that, it multiplies your ability to create great content, great business strategy, model, product, whatever it is. When you have people pulling in scattered direction, you end up pulling your product apart, and it doesn't come with a great working environment, right? So what happens if you don't do these things, right? Why are some reasons that we created this course? Well, I'm going to tell you. A couple of the reasons that we created this course were because I found that a lot of admin folks that I would work with were that go-to person. Everybody in their organization would go to them for everything. They were not, and that person would take on all of those things because there was never a system or a model to show them how to be a go-through person. What do I mean by a go-through person? Is typically, if there is no model or systems in your organization, or if there's a crack in your foundation of your systems, they don't know where to go. And what we're going to talk about is how to create a system for everything so that everyone starts assuming there's a model for it. And they're going to look for that model and want to train to it. You also know you need a new system or to change your systems and models if you keep revisiting the same issue or problem over and over again with little note or no change in the results. So we're going to talk about that as well. We're going to talk about why do we keep coming back to the same systems and models. You keep getting things back on your plate. So let's say, for example, you're trying to delegate something and that same task keeps coming on back on your plate. My guess would be that there's a systems problem there. Most people want to say that the problem is the person you were leveraging to. I'm going to suggest that it might be the system by which you delegate. Delegation has some systems to it, and how you delegate should be a system. And we're going to talk about that as well. Do you have a high staff turnover rate? Right? If you are following a good staffing policy and procedure manual and you know what you're looking for, you're asking great questions, the candidate vets out, but they don't seem to last long in your organization, but they're still a great person and you're sad that they left. We're not talking the hires that should leave. What we're talking about is the hires that you didn't want to leave, but they do leave. Typically, that comes down to organizational systems and models that they couldn't either see or feel, and therefore, we're going to talk about that as well. Do you have things that you're spending money on and your return on that investment is decreasing? Well, that's a sign of a cracked foundation in a system that we're going to talk about as well. How do you make sure that you're looking at everything month over month, week over week, depending on your system, your team, your business, and be able to say to yourself, okay, how do I trip a lever now? Because again, we used to have 110% ROI on this. Now we only have an 18%. How do we move forward in that? So again, if you're looking at your systems and models, that could be a sign that you need some help there. You need to rescue or save people in your business on a daily basis. Do you ever feel like you walk around with a life preserver and you just have to keep throwing them out to people because you have to save people? 9 times out of 10, people love that feeling. They love rescuing people until it's overwhelming. If you've ever talked to anybody who's a lifeguard, the hardest part about being a lifeguard is actually the client, right? You go out to save someone when they're drowning. What do? They cling on you. They hit you. They drown you too, right? So one of the things that they teach you in lifeguarding is how to rescue people without getting hurt yourself. And so people really love that until it's painful. But we're going to talk to you about in our course about how if you've got great systems and models in place, you won't need to rescue people. The system and model will prevent them from actually drowning in the first place. And if you're regularly looking at your models and systems, then you'll be able to figure that out. Let's say your satisfaction in your customer decreases, from your customer satisfaction numbers decrease. Again, 9 times out of 10, that is a systems problem. If your expenses are increasing disproportionately to your income. So what do I mean by that? Basically, it feels like a leak, right? You feel like a balloon that's losing air. You're spending money here, but the income isn't coming in at the same rate. Typically, there's a system or model problem there. That's probably a fiscal system, and that's part of one of our courses, one of the things we cover. And the next one, the one I love the most, is that your direct competitor is closing the gap on you. So let's say in real estate, the number one team did 200 units and you did, 180. And then the next year you beat them. You were doing 225 and they were doing 180. But this year they're doing 190 and you're still only doing 225. And then the year after that, they're doing almost 200 and you're still doing 225, right? You should be able to grow in your systems and models. And if you have good systems and models in place, and if your competitor keeps closing that gap, and you're not moving faster than they are, typically it's a systems problem. So let's talk about the topics we're going to discuss in this course. So the first thing we're going to talk about is going to start with accountability systems. We're going to talk about how to maintain accountable tools and systems in your company. We're going to talk about coaching and meetings and standards. We're going to talk about how to hire talent, systems for hiring talent, a couple of different pipelines that we use, where we find talent. And this is all going to be stuff from how her group does that. We're going to talk about the systems for hiring, including job descriptions, posting, social media. So we do a whole class on systems and models for hiring and accountability and keeping great people. We're also going to talk about the financial models and systems. We'll talk about economic fundamentals, budgets and reporting, profit and loss, financial analysis, and then what do you do once you have all that data, right? So we'll talk about that as well. We're also going to talk about big business, big standards, big profits. What's that section? Now, this is the section that most people have the most issues with because they don't feel like it's a system. But we talk about developing our mission, vision, and value, and creating a standard and culture in our team and company, and the model that you have to follow that, and the trickle-down effect that it comes from that. So that's one of the next things that we talk about. We're also going to talk about if you are in the business of lead generating on your teams, how to make sure that you are hiring the right people in your organization, people who want to work every day, or the people who want to receive every day. We talk about returns on investments for all of the money that you spent. So if you do any type of lead gen spending, we have a whole section on how to make money from and make sure we're making money from the money that we spend. And then the last one we have is a system on failure. So what does it mean, system on failure? We talk about making sure that you have a culture, a fail-forward culture. The fail-forward culture is basically creating a team and a model where you'll be able to show people in your organization how you learn from failure and move forward. Now, this is, again, another one where people are like, you really teach a class on failing? Yeah, I do, because if you're going to have a culture of failure, you have to have a system backing it up so that people know how to fail in your organization and what you're going to do when people fail. Right. And so that's a huge one. And that one, we also talk about models for time blocking, leveraging, lots of different things. And then the last thing we cover is really, how do you put it all together? How do you take everything we just talked about and put it all into a transferable, sustainable, manageable outline of things that you want to share with your team and your business and your whoever it is that you sit with every day. So that is the basic outline of Systems Without Limits in a short 20-minute blurb. Good. I'm glad you're signing up, Tom. That's awesome to know. Thanks for saying that. So questions, what do you have? Type them in your question box. What do you want to learn that I didn't cover? What are you hoping to achieve that I didn't say? Because maybe I didn't cover it, or I didn't touch on it, or maybe it's something I can throw in there that would, you know, make you want to sign up. And then I will also say, so I'm going to give you guys a second to write that in there. But the other thing I will say is I do share with you a lot of the things that we use in her group. So a lot of the things, like one of the big questions that I get asked is, you know, what system do you guys use for this? What this do you use for that? We do actually cover that. So you'll be able to see, and I will share some of the tools that we use to do what we do. So how many sessions will there be? There are four sessions, and they are jam-packed. Some of them, they're an hour, and some of them may go over because this used to be a six-session course that I'm pushing down to because the last session was a little light, so we're pushing it down to four. We're hoping we can get it into four solid sessions. So it will be four solid sessions. Also, if you purchase them and you can't make one of the calls, you can get the recordings. Also, the other thing we do is we will add you to our Systems Without Limits Facebook group. What's kind of cool about that is you can go in and see all the other questions that people have asked in the time. You can also mastermind. We do a lot of masterminding in that group as we're going through it. So if you have a problem that we didn't cover in the course, you can always just throw it in there, and I'm always available to do that as well. Would this class be helpful for a newer, smaller team, two agents, me, and an operating manager that wants to grow? Absolutely. So my opinion is that this class is for anybody who has something to grow and build. So I believe that if you're looking to grow your business and build your business, most businesses need to rebuild their foundation first and learn how to have systems and models, because you probably have someone on in your group who loves systems and models, but they may not have all the tools ready to do that. So Caleb, yes, absolutely. I do believe this would be a great class for somebody who's looking to grow a smaller team. Because again, most of what we do in expansion is basically just a small team with a big team backing it. So absolutely, 100%. Do I have a slide for the class content? That was pretty fast. I'm from Massachusetts. I talk really fast. So yes, what I can do is I can check with our administrator from the Hergen Rotha Training Organization and see if we can get a slide out of the content. So Tracy, I will try to do that, to do slide content for you. So I believe I've answered every question unless anybody has a couple of more questions that you guys want to ask. Anything you particularly want to get out of it? Oh, here comes another one. Will this cover expansion team systems for out-of-state branches? So what all of our systems are expandable systems. So sort of yes and no. What I will say is if you do have specific questions about how X or Y relates to expansion, then I will actually answer those questions for you. I'm also looking to develop a course on expansion systems. That's one of my goals for AHTO, is to create another course. But we do, people often come on because they want to learn about expansion into other states. And I do answer those questions specifically for folks if that is something that you guys want to do. So yes, I don't know if that answers your question. So like I said, the Systems Without Limits will start on March 6th. You can sign up for those. And again, this is really the four main nuggets that we're going to cover, you know, providing methods and models and systems for creating scalable systems, provide insights to increase staff productivity and retention, teach ROI tracking and sound financial practices, and teach you how to become a force multiplier. So those really are the four benchmarks that we cover. If you guys want to sign up, you can always go to hergtraining.com and look for Systems Without Limits. That bit.ly link that is on your screen right now, I'll leave that up there for a second, bit.ly/capitalsystems2018. That's how you can sign up. The classes are at 1 p.m. for 4 weeks starting March 6th, and they will be a jam-packed hour. And like I said, you can always get the recordings if you sign up and can't make them. And last but not least, this is my contact information. If you have questions about the course, you can always email me at becca@herdgroup.com. You can follow me on Facebook. You can go to Herd Training. Our class is sponsored by Boomtown. I don't spend a ton of time training on Boomtown. They're just an awesome vendor of ours who really supports our training organization. So they are the sponsor. If you are interested in Boomtown, Hunter would be the person we would ask you to call. But other than that, that is all I have, unless there's any other final questions that you guys might have. I hope some of you will sign up. I know I love teaching this class. I love answering your questions, and I truly do cater my class to answering your questions. I leave about 10 or 15 minutes at the end, and I'm willing to stay on an extra 10 or 15 minutes if we need to, if we go long. So the goal is for you each to get everything that you guys need out of the class. Once again, where's another one? Awesome. Thanks, Tracy. We look forward to having you. Tell your friends if you enjoyed what you heard today, or if you think there's somebody else that you think could benefit from this class, send them on over to me at becca@herdgroup, and I'm glad to answer any questions. So if you're thinking about signing up and are not sure, you can even call me and we can talk about it. Whatever works, I'd love to have you guys join us. Have an amazing day, everybody.